Throughout history, humankind has unlocked astonishing technological breakthroughs. Steam engines, electricity, computers, these advancements define civilization. But what if electricity wasn't a modern discovery? What if ancient civilizations had already harnessed electrical power more than 2,000 years ago? This idea, as wild as it seems, might not be mere fantasy. An artifact discovered in the 1930s has puzzled historians and scientists alike. A small, unassuming clay jar with the potential to generate electricity. In 1938, Wilhelm Koenig, an archaeologist working at the National Museum of Iraq, unearthed a peculiar object in the ruins of Ctesiphon, a city once part of the Parthian Empire. The artifact was a simple clay jar, just 6 inches tall, but what was inside would baffle researchers for decades. Inside the jar, Koenig found a copper cylinder, an iron rod, and traces of an unknown substance. When examined, the substance appeared to be remnants of an acidic liquid, possibly vinegar, lemon juice, or fermented grape juice. Koenig, an expert in ancient metallurgy, recognized something extraordinary. This setup resembled a primitive electrochemical cell. Could this be evidence that ancient civilizations harnessed electricity long before the modern world? And if so, why did they need it? What were they powering? And most importantly, what other ancient technologies might have been lost to time? Welcome to Unveiling Hidden Past, where we uncover the lost knowledge of our ancestors. In today's episode, we journey into one of the greatest technological mysteries of the ancient world, the Baghdad Battery. The Baghdad Battery is surprisingly simple in design, yet its implications are profound. The setup of a copper cylinder, an iron rod, and an acidic liquid mirrors the basic principle of a galvanic cell, the foundation of modern batteries. Here's how it works. When an acidic electrolyte is poured into the jar, the copper and iron react, causing electrons to flow. This process generates an electrical charge. Scientists have tested replicas of the Baghdad battery and found that it could generate approximately 0.8 to 1.1 volts. Not much by today's standards, but still functional as a power source. But what exactly could this have powered? That's where the theories begin. One of the strongest theories is that the Baghdad battery was used for electroplating, a process where an electric current deposits a thin layer of metal onto another surface. Ancient civilizations were highly skilled in metallurgy and jewelry making, and electroplating would have allowed them to create elaborate gold-plated artifacts with precision. Modern scientists have replicated the device and successfully used it to coat small objects in gold using a similar technique. This theory suggests that artisans in the Parthian or Sasanian empires may have known more about electrochemistry than previously believed. If true, this would mean that ancient artisans weren't just experimenting with metalwork, they were actively using chemical engineering to refine their crafts. Could this be evidence of an undiscovered tradition of scientific knowledge in the ancient world? Another possibility is that the Baghdad battery wasn't a tool for artisans, but rather an instrument for religious rituals. Imagine an ancient priest using the device to create a small electrical shock, convincing followers that they were witnessing divine power. In many cultures, lightning and electricity were seen as the manifestation of gods. If priests could generate even a small static shock from the battery, it could have been used to inspire awe and maintain religious control. This idea may seem speculative, but history offers intriguing parallels. Ancient Egyptian temples sometimes used hidden devices to create optical illusions, and in some cases, controlled fire and water to make it appear as though the gods were influencing reality. Could the Baghdad battery have been part of a secret ritualistic practice? Another possibility is that the Baghdad battery was used for therapeutic purposes. Even in modern times, low voltage electricity is used in muscle stimulation therapies and pain relief treatments. Could the ancients have discovered a primitive form of electrotherapy? We know from historical texts that ancient Greek and Roman physicians experimented with electrical charges from torpedo fish, marine creatures capable of generating electric shocks to treat headaches and joint pain. Could the Parthians have been using a similar method with the Baghdad Battery? Of course, not everyone is convinced that the Baghdad Battery was a power source. Many skeptics argue that it was nothing more than a simple storage jar used to hold scrolls or religious documents. One of the biggest counter-arguments is the lack of accompanying evidence. If the Parthians had mastered electricity, why haven't we found wires, conductors, or other electrical artifacts from the same period? Why didn't they leave behind written records describing its use? Skeptics suggest that the resemblance to a modern battery is pure coincidence, and that Koenig's interpretation of the artifact was influenced by modern scientific understanding rather than actual historical evidence. If the Baghdad Battery was truly an electrical device, the implications are staggering. It would mean that ancient civilizations had a deeper understanding of electricity than previously believed. This raises even bigger questions. Could there be more lost technologies waiting to be uncovered? Some argue that technological progress isn't always linear. Throughout history, knowledge has been discovered, lost, and rediscovered multiple times. Could the Baghdad Battery be evidence of a scientific breakthrough that was later forgotten? Could the knowledge of electricity have existed long before modern science, only to vanish over time? But until more evidence is found, we may never know for certain. The Baghdad Battery remains one of the most debated artifacts in history, a puzzle with no clear answer. Was it truly an ancient power source or just an ordinary object misinterpreted by modern minds? What do you think? Was the Baghdad Battery an ancient breakthrough or just a fascinating coincidence? Let us know in the comments. And if you love uncovering history's forgotten stories, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to Unveiling Hidden Past. Until next time, keep seeking the truth.